Pearl Pereira. Welcome to my sewing room. Today I'd like to show you my new quilt pattern, which is called All My Favorite Things. The pattern comes with a stencil for stenciling all the fine detail. Inside the pattern, you'll also find color photos step by step of how I did the technique and a color guide for where I used each color with a photo of each of the elements that I used the stenciling on. Now it's time for us to get started. I'm going to show you some of the tools and items that you'll need to do. I've gathered together all the items that you'll need. Of course, you'll need your pattern and your template. And you're going to want to take a copy of the area that you want to stencil. It's just a lot easier to work if you have a copy handy. I have a light box. You want to cut 6-inch squares for each of the pieces that you're going to stencil. Some freezer paper cut to about 7 inches by 6 inches. Once you have these two, you're going to iron your piece of fabric to your freezer paper. I have that ready, and then we also need some freezer paper to use as a palette. You're going to need your Shiva paint sticks, and they're little oil paint sticks, and you'll also need some stencil brushes. I like to use one for each color. It just makes it easier when you're working. I also have the shape of the template and the area of where it's supposed to go. To start with, I'm going to do the canary snaps, and I just need to know that my fabric will have enough seam allowance all the way around it. And of course, my fabric piece is 6 inches, so you definitely know that you'll have enough fabric to go all the way around. First thing I want to do is I want to take my copy and I'm going to place it on a light box. And then I'm going to take my piece of fabric that's already been ironed to my freezer paper and I'm going to place it centered on the fabric. You need some blue tape and you're going to blue tape your freezer paper to your pattern so that it doesn't shift on you. The next thing we're going to do is we're going to take our template and you're going to find the element that you want to work on, and in this case it's the canary snaps. And I can lay this on here, I can find my perfect position, and I will once again use some blue tape to hold my stencil in place so that it stays in place. Now you can take this off your light box or you can leave it on there, and I generally just leave it there while I'm working. And now we need to prepare our paint sticks. I believe that the canary snaps is green, so I used, I believe, sap green. Now paint sticks are kind of like a lipstick, and they get a very hard film on them. This paint will not come off, it dries. So what you need to do is you need to, with an X-Acto knife, you need to remove a small layer of this. Someone said this was like peeling a very expensive lipstick, and I thought that was very true. So you want to take off a slight amount. You just want to get to the area where the paint is actually now moist. And then you're going to take your stencil brush. This is a 1/4-inch stencil brush. And I just kind of apply some of the paint right to the brush by just brushing it in here. And then I'm going to rub it on my palette and work it so that I can get it into the bristles of the brush. Once I know that I have my paint ready, then I'm going to start with my stenciling. They do have in this kit that I bought, of course it didn't come in this cute little box, but it was 15 paint sticks and a blender. Now the blender is clear, and just like the other ones, you do need to remove that first layer that dries. And what you do with the blender is it just helps make your paint more fluid. Okay, so you're just going to put some of that on there if you need to. I find that it's very useful to do that. Generally, I like to just take some off of there and put it on the side so that I don't have to always be constantly cleaning the end of my paint stick. So once I think I have enough blender and enough paint on here, I'm going to start. And I use two different methods of applying the paint. The first one, which is the basic one, and I'm going to show you this right now, is just the stippling effect. And if I can get in closer, yes. Okay, good. Okay. And what this is, it's an up and down motion. Okay, and the area that I'm working in is right here. I know this is probably very hard to see, but I'm just going to be pouncing my stencil brush in the area where each of the letters appears. It's very quick, it's very easy, makes perfect letters. And the beauty of the oil paint sticks is that they dry in 24 hours. Actually, it seems like they dry even sooner than that. But when they do dry, they're soft to the touch and can be washed. Also, the beauty of the paint stick is that it doesn't bleed. It doesn't bleed like inking with a pen. Wherever you're applying this paint, that is exactly where it's going to stay. Now, you can do it lightly and just have your letters shaded lightly. In this case, I kind of wanted them to be solid fill. So I'm just carefully going in and just stippling in with this up and down movement. And as you can see, I am getting more paint on my brush as I need it. And I'm going to continue until I have all the letters completely filled. You can scrub slightly when you're doing this. It doesn't hurt anything. I would just say that some of the letters have interior areas that are very small. You might want to, like inside the A or inside an E, you want to just basically go up and down in those areas just to make sure that you don't distort your template. Okay, now our Canary Snaps stenciling is done. I'm going to put this down, and one of the things I like to do is I like to lift it up and check and see if it looks exactly the way I want. And it does. So now I'm going to remove my blue tape and reveal how beautifully the inking is for the Canary Snaps. Now you're going to set this aside and you're going to let this dry. Oh, it says 24 hours, but iron it with an iron and then it'll be permanent. These can be washed multiple times. Nothing bleeds, and it's very soft to the touch once it's finished. The next template I want to show you is the one that is two-part template, the Bluebird. The Bluebird has part one and part two, and also the B has a part one and part two to the template. So you want to do part one template first, and then you'll apply part two. The other thing about your templates is you can cut them apart to make them easier to work with. I already have this set up here, and I want to make sure, because the head, the tip of the wing and the head are very close to my bluebird lettering, and also the branch down here. So I cut a piece of blue tape, and in this case, I wanted to try with my scissors, and I just kind of made a nice little curve so it kind of follows the contour of the pattern, okay? The other thing is, I always fold up one little end of it, so it makes it easier for you to grab when you're ready to take this off of here. For the red, I used alizarin crimson, one of my very favorite colors, and I'm getting my brush filled. Now, the lettering is just as we did before. It's straight, stippling up and down until you fill in each of the letters. It goes very, very quickly, and it really requires not that much paint. I love how nice and crisp the letters come out using this technique. There's no bleeding. It's just a very nice finished look when you're done. Okay, so now the next thing we would do on template number one is we want to put in the coloring for our branch. Might need to get a little more paint on here. And we're going to fill in. Now this template is marked 1 and 2, and you'll see that these lines are just scored in. And you can keep it light if you'd like. You can brush this in. You can make it darker by pouncing harder. You know, there's many different looks that you can get working with a stencil and the oil sticks. Now, once I have these two done, it's time for me to do my actual bird. So again, I want to be careful, and I don't want to get color where I don't want it. So I'm just going to come back with a piece of tape and cover up the areas that I want to make sure that I'm not going to get any paint on. So I'm going to start with the belly. The belly is alizarin crimson, which is a really wonderful red color. And the red only goes in his belly area, right here. So you're going to start, and this is the feathering technique. You're going to start off the body, and we can kind of make the edge a little bit darker if you'd like, and then just kind of feather. You go up, flipping up, flipping up, flipping up, so that it's dark to light. And if you want to really make that edge really nice and strong, just give it a little bit more on the edge. Now, once that area is exactly the way you like it, you're going to come back and you're going to get your phthalo blue, another wonderful color. Load your brush, and the same thing. I want to start off of my template and just feather in, making it lighter towards the center. The same thing applies to the end of his tail out here. Now, once we have this the way I would like it, then I'm going to remove the template and we'll position number two, okay? So we're removing this, have it exactly the way I would like it to look. And now I need to turn my light box back on so that I can see the position of the pattern underneath. This may not look very good from your view, but now I can exactly position my template where it's supposed to be. His beak should be touching his head, his eye, and get this exactly where it needs to be. And once I have it in position, I'm going to put another couple pieces of blue tape on here. And I can see where I just got a little paint on there. Okay, So now we're ready to do his wing. Now the wing was pretty much solid blue. We kept it dark next to the body. So we're gonna come in here and we're gonna go dark next to the body. Oh, it helps if I turn this off. We'll be dark next to the body. It can be lighter out at the end. And the tail, we want to have that kind of dark at the end, a little light shading. Mine look different every time I make one of these. So, but you can practice your feathering technique off of the template, on the template. You want to intensify any color, just come along the edge and define that color slightly darker. Okay? Once you have your wing and your tail exactly the way you'd like them, then you need to finish with the beak and the eye. And the beak and the eye are black. This is ivory black. And it's just these two little areas right here. You're just going to stipple those until you start seeing the area fill in. And once you have that filled in, you're done. So now let's remove this. And you do need to be careful with your paint when you're working. As you can see, I did get a little of the brown ink over here. I mean, brown paint over here. But that happens, and it's a good thing this is just an example. So once I turn this around, you can see how it came out. I have another one right here, which came out slightly darker. And like I said, every time I do this, they come out different. For the sewing bird and needles, you're going to do basically the same technique. Although this is just one template, so you will want to use tape over here at the tip of the needle so that you don't get any of the blue in there or you don't get any black into your lettering. The B is also the other one, which is a two-part template. The first part is the actual beeswax and the wing, and those are two different colors. So the beeswax is blue, and you do the wings and the stripes in the yellow ochre. Then you're going to put your second template on top of there, and you'll fill in with black, and that gives him his head, his body parts, and the little line that he's flying along. Those are my tips on how to do the stenciling. I hope you enjoyed this video. Look for other videos on applique on my website, and I hope to be seeing you there. Thank you.